this life I cannot change. And it is deep off in the main. Hello and welcome to another edition of Middleware Friday for August 18th, 2017. This is episode 29. And today we're going to be talking about automating content insights using Azure Video Indexer Service, Microsoft Flow, Azure Data Lake Storage, and Power BI. No community content this week, as we've got more than enough content to fill up this episode. So first off, I got to call out the inspiration of this edition of Middleware Friday. Didn't come all from myself. What I do want to do is call out to Anika Zaman, I hope I get that correct, who wrote a blog post around building custom video AI workflows with Video Indexer and Logic Apps. And while everything I'm going to show you today can be done with Logic Apps, I figured I would extend the scenario, but I would also go ahead and use Flow. But certainly you don't have to use Flow, you can continue to use Logic Apps if you wish. Before we begin, I do want to introduce a few concepts, a few Azure services that we haven't talked about before. One of them is going to be Azure Data Lake Storage. Now, when some of you folks filled out the surveys, appreciate that, you wanted to hear more about Azure Data Lake. So I'm not saying I'm an expert. Certainly that is not the case. We did an internal presentation last week. One of my colleagues was talking about it. I thought it was pretty interesting, and I thought it was worth including in this week's edition of Middleware Friday. So what is Azure Data Lake Store? Azure Data Lake Store is an enterprise-wide hyperscale repository for big data analytic workloads. It enables you to capture data of any size, type, and ingestion speed in a single place for operational and exploratory analytics. Now, if you do look at the diagram here, you can see there's different phases or stages of a pipeline. You can kind of think of this as almost like the Vedder pipeline that we've seen in MABS and to a certain extent Logic Apps, but you do have the ability to ingest data in a native format, and that can come from a variety of different sources. Could be, you know, web, could be devices, so you have telemetry, IoT type data. You could have click streams where you're basically subscribing to events off of a web application. Once you have that data, you want to be able to store it, but you may want to prepare or do some level of pre-processing around it. And you can go ahead and do that using the analytic capabilities that exist inside of Azure Data Lakes. Next, you want to store and retain it for, you know, whatever duration that you want. And then on top of that, you can use the analytic engines, including Hadoop and Spark, that will then process the data that's been stored within the data lake. Now, some more specifics around Azure Data Lake Store. The Data Lake Store is an Apache Hadoop file system compatible with distributed file system. The data can be easily analyzed using Hadoop tools and frameworks including MapReduce and Hive. Azure Data Lake Store provides unlimited storage and is suitable for storing a variety of data for analytics. So this can be from kilobytes to petabytes in size. It's built or it's intended to run large scale analytic systems that require massive throughput to query and analyze large amounts of data. The data lake spreads parts of a file over a number of individual storage servers from an HA and scalability perspective. Now, it does have industry standard availability and reliability built in, and your data assets are stored durably by making redundant copies to guard against unexpected failures. Now, to provision an Azure Data Lake Store, you simply go into the Azure portal, you look for storage, and then what you'll find is the Data Lake Store. You can go ahead and click on that, and when you do, you're going to get asked for the typical Azure information, including a name for the service, a subscription, a resource group, a location, and pricing. Now, what is pretty interesting about Azure Data Lake Store is pay-as-you-go, and the organization that I work for, this has been very attractive for us. One scenario we ran into was we had implemented a new version of a system, so we'd retired the old system. It was a vendor that no longer was building those types of systems anymore, and we implemented a new solution based upon a different vendor. But for historical and regulatory purposes, we still had to maintain a copy of all of that data for several years. Now, this was previously stored within an Oracle database, but what we actually did is we took
extracts from those systems, loaded them into Azure Data Lakes, where we still have the ability to query that data set. We can address all of our compliance needs, but we're reducing our costs significantly. Not only are we getting rid of Oracle as a license, but we're also getting rid of on-premise storage. And we can now throw that in the cloud, query it when we need to, and pay not a whole lot for the storage that's provided inside of Azure. For example, you can see here that you get a terabyte for $35 USD. That's pretty much unheard of in an enterprise on-premise data center configuration. Once we go ahead and provision this, we will just take a few moments and then we'll actually have an Azure Data Lake store. One thing you want to do when you have an Azure Data Lake store is you want to create different folder structures or a taxonomy. So for the purpose of this episode, I'm going to create a folder called Middleware Friday Analysis, where we'll be able to write out our analytical data from the Azure Video Indexer service and output those results into this folder that sits within the Azure Data Lake store. Next up, what is the Azure Video Indexer service? So the Azure Video Indexer service is a cloud service that enables you to extract the following insight from your videos using artificial intelligence technologies. Now, I've only included a subset of the overall capabilities, but I thought these were the pretty important ones. So one is audio transcription. So this service is able to take speech to text and actually give you a transcription of what was said within your video clip. It also is capable of detecting faces using some of the cognitive services that we've seen before in previous episodes. It's able to do speaker indexing, so it can map and understand which speaker spoke words and when. So imagine you had multiple speakers in a video clip and you wanted to be able to record what one person said versus the other. This service is capable of doing that. It can detect scenes. So it'll use visual analysis from the video to determine when a scene changes in a video. It also provides sentiment analysis, so it can determine the sentiment, much like we've seen before as well, using confidence levels, and give you overall sentiment based upon how the speakers are using language to express their points of view. The service can also provide some level of translation, and there's several languages that it's able to do, to the link below that we'll go through in each one. It's also able to do keyword extraction. So if there's specific keywords that keep on being used over and over, it'll detect that and identify those keywords. And last, annotation. So the video indexer annotates the video based upon 2,000 predefined models. Now the service itself can be accessed over the web by going to vi.microsoft.com. And there's really two modes where you can use this service. You can use it, one, just from a web page without writing any code. You can upload video clips, analyze them, perform searches, and get insight that you actually want out of it. Or you can actually go ahead and use the API. And you can access the API by clicking on the API reference link below and then subscribing to the Video Indexer API service. Now there is a free preview. If this interface looks familiar, it's because they must be using Azure API Management to manage all of their access to their APIs. But you can go ahead and subscribe for free. Once you've done that, you then can use the API or you can use connectors for use within Microsoft Flow or Azure Logic Apps. Or if you prefer a no-code solution, you can just go ahead and use the user interface. Now, just to give you a flavor of what the service provides, I can go ahead and search for a specific text or topic within the transcript of the videos that I've uploaded. Now, in a previous episode, I talked about Azure Active Directory and I had the Richard Sroder as a user within my system and I wanted to add him to specific groups. So what I did is I just searched for Richard and then it'll go ahead and inspect all of the videos where Richard's name was used and give me a time frame when it was actually used. So that's sort of one of the core features of this particular service is you take a video, you throw it up in the service, and then you can go ahead and analyze that. So you think about, you know, all organizations that have lots of content and how you want to be able to search that content it'd be very difficult otherwise. You know, historically, you'd be transcribing this, which takes forever. But now we've got these cognitive services that's going to automate a lot of that for us. So the scenario I want to talk about today is, you know, one that I've, you know, alluded to just on the previous slide. And it's the idea that I want to take all of my Middleware Friday episodes and actually have the transcriptions for all of the episodes. So as I mentioned, we're up to episode 29, and that's pretty interesting. But even in my head, even though I've recorded, you know, most of these, with the exception of the couple that Steph Jan did, it's hard to keep track of all of the different topics that I've spoken about. So now I'm going to have the ability to take these video clips, upload it into OneDrive, have Microsoft Flow subscribe to those events, pull the video clips down, and pass them to the Azure Video Indexer Service. The Video Indexer Service will then provide all of the analysis and the transcription and store it in an Azure Data Lake. Now, once it's in an Azure Data Lake storage, I can then wire up Power BI. And Power BI is going to give me a nice interface where I can use different visualizations in order to extract the insight that the Video Indexer Service has provided. Now, one of the current limitations, and it's called out in the previous blog post from Microsoft, was that OneDrive currently has a 50 megabyte limitation for the size of a file that can be consumed into Flow or Logic Apps. So in order to keep this video clip small, I'm going to stop the recording now, and we're going to use the recording up until this point to go ahead and drive insight off of it. So what I'll do is I'll come back and I'll have run this video clip up until this point through the insights, and we'll be able to explore it within Power BI. Okay, we're back. So what I've done is I've gone ahead and rendered that video in Camtasia. So now I've got an MP4 file, which we can actually use to perform video analysis against. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you the flow workflow first. And if we head over to flow.microsoft.com and we type in video indexer in the template section, what we will see is a couple templates that we can use in order to accelerate our development experience. So I'm going to head and use this one, but let's jump over to the actual finished product and I will walk you through step by step what's going on here. So the first thing that I did was use the OneDrive connector. And in this case, I need to log into my Hotmail identity, and then I can go ahead and configure my OneDrive folder that I want to be looking for new videos in. Next, I want to go ahead and use the upload video and index operation, which is part of the Azure Video Indexer connector. And what I need to do is I need to provide the file content, which is going to come from my OneDrive action. I also need to provide a file name, and I can choose whether or not I want the video that's going to be uploaded to the service to be in a private or public repository. So for now, I'm just leaving it as private, but you might have some use cases where you want it to be public. Now, as you can imagine, it will take some time to actually analyze the video clip. In this case, my video clip is around 32 megs. So that's going to take a few minutes to actually go ahead and process. So what we do is we can go ahead and use a do until action that allows us to go ahead and check the state of our processing in order to determine whether or not it's complete. In this case, state is going to be coming from the get processing state action, which is below. And what we need to do is to provide the video ID from our upload video and index action. Now, what will happen is every time we go through this loop and we call this operation, the state will be returned. And in this case, when it's processed, then we'll stop because we know that it's complete. Otherwise, we're going to introduce a delay. And this is really just to reduce the amount of computations that need to occur unnecessarily. So this value is relatively arbitrary, but for this case, I'm using 1 minute. Now, what'll happen is once the processing state has been set to processed, we can go ahead and get the video breakdown by passing that video ID once again, which was returned from this action. Next, we're going to go ahead and upload the insights to our Azure Data Lake storage. Now, in this case, there's multiple, properties that are returned from our get video breakdown action. Now, the ones that I'm interested in are the breakdown arrays. Now, this is really the details of the video. So essentially, almost like line by line, it's going to break down the text and the time frame and additional information pertaining to that, basically that sentence that was said. The other thing we can do is get the summarized insights, and this is what was used in the blog post example from Microsoft. And this is going to output a much smaller file that's going to give a summary of some of the keywords that were used, the overall sentiment, whether or not it was able to detect faces and speakers within the actual video clip itself. So I'm going to go ahead and close this now. And we're going to go ahead and upload the latest video. So I'm going to go ahead and drag that over here. Now we'll pause the recording because this is going to take a few minutes to process. And then I'll go ahead and show you the results. All right, so we're back. And the process is run. And now what we will find if we go into our Azure Data Lake store and go into the Data Explorer, we see our folder that we created earlier, and now we have two messages. We've got the summary and we've got the details for the actual insights that were generated through Azure Video Indexer. Now, to give you a sense of what's included in these files, I'm now back in the Video Indexer service itself. And what we will determine is we've got a series of keywords that have been identified as the result of the analysis that was performed against this video clip. It has also detected the sentiment, indicating that I'm mostly positive. There's a few parts where I'm negative, so that's kind of interesting to perhaps understand where that could be coming from. But this gives us a high-level summary of what was included inside the video clip. Now, we can get into the details, and the details will go line by line, and exactly the time frame, as you can see here, this happened at the 20-second mark, of what was said. And here, we can go ahead and search if we wish. Now, we have the ability to play, so I'm not going to play it because the audio will get messed up with the actual recording itself. But when you do go ahead and hit play, it'll actually keep track of exactly where you are within the transcript itself. Now, you also have the ability to go ahead and edit any sort of mistakes that may occur. Now, it isn't 100% perfect, the transcription that is, but it gets you probably 85 to 90% of the way. And then you can simply do a little bit of cleanup, which makes it way easier than trying to do this manually. I know in some of my experiences writing for InfoQ, where I go ahead and watch some supplementary video clips, I may want to pull out quotes from some of those video clips, and it can be very tedious to try to do that manually, whereas you could actually run that video clip through the Azure Video Indexer, and it's going to get you pretty close to the way. Okay, so now getting out of here and back over to the Azure Data Lake store. So that's really what's represented in these different files. So let's go ahead and click on the summary, and we're going to get an actual JSON file that represents all of the data that we just saw. Now, obviously, within the web application, it gives you it's a little bit more digestible, but essentially we have access to the data from this particular view. Now we can also jump into the details, which is a much larger file, and it's going to give us the actual line-by-line transcription of what was recorded. So this is of interest to me, and I'm going to be able to then take this data and load it into Power BI. So that's the next part of this actual solution. I'm now in Power BI and I'm in the desktop tool where I've actually ingested the data, so both the summary and the details, into Power BI. I've constructed a data model, as you can see on the right hand side, and I now have access to all of this data that was produced as a result of using the Azure Video Indexer, and this was published through Microsoft Flow and the Power BI real-time data connector. Now what we can do is we can go into the search text, and now what this is a control or a visualization that I had downloaded from the Power BI marketplace. And so this is called Smart Filter by OKViz, and this is a free visualization that's available. So now I can go in here and just type in different keywords, and it's actually going to go ahead and figure out exactly when they were used. So if I want to know exactly what part of the video clip I was talking about Azure Active Directory, I can go ahead and see Azure and type in Active Directory. And I talked about it once, so I can go ahead and click on that, and it'll now tell me exactly when I talked about it. So it was at the 9 minute and 33 second mark that I did talk about Azure Active Directory. Go ahead and close out from that, and let's take another example of maybe just middleware. If I'm talking about Middleware Friday, right here I talked about it at the 10:30 mark, and so that's pretty cool. So you can imagine if you start to accumulate a large amount of video and you want to be able to index that video and then search against it, then obviously using Power BI, this is a very powerful tool. Another thing that I've done is I've used a visualization called Word Cloud, once again a free visualization from the Power BI store, which you can get from here. Let's just open this. And is there ever a lot? It's been a while since I've been in the store, but there's a lot of different visualizations available. So that's this one here, Word Cloud. I can also type in search, and that's where we find the Smalt Filter by OKViz, which I previously showed you. Now here, all it is just a visualization of what are the words that tended to appear a lot within the actual video. Now obviously you're going to have some pretty popular words like the and to and you, but if we drive down a little bit deeper, let's see here, we can say Azure. You know, I can go ahead and click on Azure, and now all of a sudden, you know, my detail table is populated with all of the sentences or lines where Azure shows up. I can go ahead and deselect that. If I want to say Microsoft, I can go ahead and click Microsoft, and there's four occurrences of that. So certainly this is way easier than trying to, you know, fast forward, rewind through actual video clips themselves in order to try to figure out when something was mentioned. You know, there's always that situation where it's like, oh, I remember hearing this, but I don't know exactly where it is. Whereas if you have all of this data indexed, now you certainly have the ability to do that. And you can also take this much, much further. So using the video indexer service, it has the ability to identify faces. So this gets pretty interesting now. You could actually have the ability of, once you've configured it for that, of knowing who said something when. Which, if you have even more data, more video, becomes even that much of a greater value. So quickly, I'm going to show you how you can go ahead and consume some of this data, because it is a little tricky dealing with this nested JSON structure that is provided by the Azure Video Indexer service. So I'll give you a very quick tutorial on how you can at least consume some of this data for use. So the first thing you want to do is you want to go ahead and get data. And once we've selected Get Data, we now have the ability to use one of the Power BI connectors in order to ingest this data set. To simplify things, we'll go ahead and click on Azure, and we can select Azure Data Lake Store. Now the URL that we will provide comes from the Azure portal. Within the overview tab of our Azure Data Lake Store, we will see the URI for our Azure Data Lake Store. You can now go ahead and click OK. And what will happen is it will go through that folder in the Data Lake Store and ingest some data. And at this point, it's detected this particular data set and it thinks the content is a table. So I'm going to go ahead and click on load. And once I've done so, I'm going to then click on edit queries. Now I'm just going to delete these. These were from previous explorations. And here we've got query 3. Now what we can do is click on table. So here's our two different files that exist. We've got the summary and the details. Let's go ahead and click on the details file. Now this is a little bit of a convoluted step, but I haven't found a better way of doing this. Now in this case, we've got essentially our data set as a blob, like it's all contained within one column and one record, which doesn't really help us out. So go ahead and click on the X, and now we'll see the raw file represented here. We can go ahead and click, right mouse click on it, and then select JSON. And now what it'll do is actually treat it as a JSON object, which allows us to traverse it much easier. So we can go ahead and click on record. And now we're really just driving down the JSON as if it's a tree. We can click on insights. And we can click on transcript blocks. Now here what we'll do is we'll go ahead and convert this to a table. And the goal of this is once it's in a table, we can start to drill down further into it and actually get more fidelity in the actual data itself. Because you can think of these JSON files as they're fairly complex. It's a bunch of nested arrays that do exist. So you have to continue to build out this structure in order for it to work within a relational table data set. Now, what we can do is then go ahead and break this down again for lines. And we want to expand to new rows. And then we'll go ahead and click this again. And then we're going to see all of the different columns. And what we're really interested in is text, because that's going to have all of our different lines for the text. So now they're going to show up here so we can see line by line exactly what was said. Now, in order to make this, you know, queryable from a timeline perspective, we can go ahead and expand the time range. And we'll go ahead and do this. And now we can see the begin time, the end time, and the actual comment itself. So we can go into much more detail and keep working in this sort of a model, but we'll just close and apply. This is going to give us enough data for what we want to use just in this example. Now here's essentially our data set, which is going to include all of our different columns that are available to us. And now we can just go ahead and use the table visualization and then include our text, and let's go with our time range, so basically start and end. And so here's just initial insights in terms of what was said and when it was said. And then as I showed you in the actual Power BI model, you can then go ahead and pull in additional visualizations in order to slice and dice this data differently. So hopefully that gives you a decent walkthrough of how you can actually deal with the JSON files that are being extracted out of the Azure Video Indexer service. So that concludes this episode of Middleware Friday. Thanks for watching. I definitely recommend checking out the Video Indexer service, especially if you do anything with media within your organization. And I really think that whether or not you're doing media today, you'll probably be doing more and more media tomorrow or in the days to come, just largely related to the prevalence of video that now exists. You know, we're starting to do a lot more recordings whenever we do present internally, and because we want to preserve that content, we want to make it available to others that may not have been able to join live. But you add the ability to provide insight and do some indexing, it makes actually searching those videos much more efficient, especially if you need to refer back to a different particular segment or scenario. Once again, I want to thank you, BizTalk 360, for being a great partner of the show. Also recommend you check out the Integrate 2017 USA webpage, link is right here, because there is an early bird special right now, and you don't want to miss that if you are planning on attending Integrate, a great lineup of speakers in Redmond campus, right on site of Microsoft's headquarters. So it'll be a great event. I've been there before, and I'm sure it'll be a great time once again. So take care, and we'll catch you next time on Middleware Friday.
For this life I cannot change. In the hills, deep off in the main. Eminem, sweet like candy cane. Drop the top, pop it, let it bang. For this life I cannot change.